was red hot and headed to the top when police say she was murdered by the founder of her own fan club.
Selena was coming out of the room yelling, help, help.
Just another obsessed fan?
She had no other life.
Or a secret she could no longer hide.
You believe that she was taking money from the fan club.
Victoria Corderi on the day the music died.
Studios in New York, here is Stone Phillips.
Good evening. She was young and beautiful and a star. But the trail she was blazing through the music world was cut tragically short just 1 week ago tonight by murder. The woman accused of that murder was a fan, perhaps her biggest fan. She didn't hide her love for the young star. But was she hiding something else? Here's Victoria Corderi.
In Corpus Christi, thousands of fans flooded the street where their idol lived and the motel where she died. They scrawled messages, left gifts, held vigils, trying to make sense of the senseless. All of this for a young woman you may not have heard of, but who was at the center of a sensational story of obsession, greed, and manipulation. At 23, Selena was a one-name wonder. A plucky Tex-Mex singing sensation with a $1 million record deal, endorsements, a Grammy, even her own line of clothing. And it seems now, a haunting take on her future.
I just hope still to be alive, hopefully singing still, and maybe later on, 10 years down the road, I hope to have a family by then.
No one could have anticipated what really awaited Selena Quintanilla down the road. Until last week, she had it all and was going for even more. She was on the verge of realizing her crossover dream, recording her first album in English. Until last week.
911, what is your location?
Days Inn Motel, it's 901 Navigation Boulevard.
Oh, what's wrong, ma'am?
We have a woman ran in the lobby, said she's been shot. She's laid on the floor and there's blood.
Selena was shot in the back. Before dying, the young star named her killer. Police say it was her biggest fan.
Female entertainer, female vocalist, Selena Quintanilla!
Selena always seemed destined for success, not murder in a motel parking lot. Even as a little girl, she had a big voice. Selena's father, an ex-musician, freely admits he was fulfilling his own fantasies through his daughter.
I saw a way to get back into the music world through my daughter. Maybe I made a wrong decision, because look what it has led up to.
There were many lean years, but by the mid-80s, Selena was starting to make it big in the Hispanic market.
I don't think anybody could keep their eyes on anything else. She was just so, she didn't even need a spotlight, you know, she'd be up there.
Selena's husband, Chris Perez.
What were her dreams?
The English album and her clothing line. She lived for drawing her clothing and anything that had to do with clothing.
It was that breakneck schedule of performing and designing clothes that eventually brought Selena together with this woman, Yolanda Saldívar. She was a former nurse who became president of the first Selena fan club in 1991. 8 months ago, she was hired to help run Selena's boutique.
We never had really checked into anything other than that she was the fan club member, and she looked like a nice person.
She was manipulative. She was mean. She was evil.
Martin Gomez helped Selena design her clothing line and worked alongside Yolanda Saldívar.
She was trying to put a barrier between Selena and I, and Selena and anybody, you know, and it just got really bad towards the end.
What was your sense of the hold that Yolanda seemed to have over Selena?
Selena trusted her. She was trusting, she was caring, she was very naive, you know, and Yolanda jumped on that.
Selena was Yolanda's life?
She had no other life.
She was an obsessed fan.
When did that hit you?
I knew that for some time, but I didn't really worry too much about it.
But you didn't think she was dangerous?
No, not to that point.
For 8 months, Yolanda was able to live the life of a celebrity through Selena. She had control of the purse strings for the boutique and the fan club. She lavished all of her attention on Selena, even gave her this ring as a gift. But problems began to surface at the boutique.
So bills weren't being paid?
Yeah, bills weren't being paid, you know, and I tell her, what's going on? She goes, she'd say, I send that check.
At the same time, Selena's father says other financial irregularities began cropping up. He says he began to receive complaints from people who had paid to become members of the fan club, but who'd received nothing for their money. He also says he discovered a paper trail of forged checks and unpaid bills, all of it leading back to Yolanda Saldivar.
Me and my other daughter and Selena had a meeting with her and showed her what we had.
And what happened at that meeting?
She couldn't answer anything. She just, her answers were ridiculous.
Selena's family says Yolanda disappeared to Mexico a month ago, taking with her financial records from the boutique.
There was a time when everybody trusted her, you know, and anyway, for her to work her way in and then start being pushed out, I don't think she could handle it.
Yolanda resurfaced 2 weeks ago at this motel. She called Selena to tell her she had the missing financial records. And the family says she concocted a bizarre story about having been raped. The next day, Selena came here to take Yolanda to a local hospital to get checked out. It was a fateful meeting.
Family and police sources told Dateline that on the morning of the murder, Selena drove Yolanda to this hospital, where during an examination, she admitted she had not been raped. Back at the motel, Selena removed the ring Yolanda had given her and apparently severed all ties. This motel maid says she saw what happened after that.
I turned around, I saw Yolanda and Selena coming out from 158, and Selena was coming out of the room yelling, help, help. And that's when Yolanda, you know, shot her in the back. Yolanda announced, you bitch, and then she turned around.
Selena stumbled into the lobby, bleeding to death from a severed artery. Police say the singer was found clutching the ring Yolanda had given her.
It's when the call came in that Selena had been in an accident to go to the emergency room.
And when you got there?
The doctor came in and told me that she was dead on arrival.
Word got out that Selena had been shot. Hundreds of fans gathered near the motel parking lot, witnessing a bizarre standoff between police SWAT teams and Yolanda sitting in a truck. For nearly 10 hours, she held a gun to her head, threatening to kill herself.
They rushed her and grabbed her. They rushed in the front of the white pickup, grabbed her. She's on the ground.
Finally, Saldivar surrendered and was placed under a suicide watch. She has since pleaded not guilty to murder. Her lawyer declined comment on both the murder charges and the allegations of financial misconduct.
When you heard Selena had been shot, what occurred to you?
I knew it was Yolanda. Instantly, she wanted to get back at Selena, and she figured, hey, I did all this for you. If I can't have you, no one else can, and she killed her.
Selena's memorial service resembled a state funeral. 8,000 white roses, her favorite, were placed near her casket.
I didn't think I was going to make it through that, you know. I just wanted to wake her up. I could see her, like, when she'd be asleep, you know, and she'd be like that. And she looked beautiful even like that. She was always giving people the benefit of the doubt, you know, and look what it got her.
No one really knows what dark impulses may have driven Selena's accused murderer. Ironically, in the end, Selena did achieve a kind of twisted crossover dream. Through headlines, Selena finally was famous with an American audience as the victim of an apparently obsessed fan.